Check this out. 5 times the same sentence and 5 times nicht is on a different position. Why? Hallo liebe Deutschstudentinnen und Deutschstudenten, if you are new here, welcome to Your German Teacher. My name is Luzi and I'm here to help you to improve your German. In this video we will talk about the position of nicht, the negation nicht. Where can you put it and why? Nicht steht vor dem Satzglied, das verneint wird. In English, the word nicht, not, stands in front of the sentence elements which you want to negate. Or shorter, nicht precedes what it negates. And this is, we call it a rule. It is almost a rule because there's only one exception. I will come to this exception just in a second. But otherwise, you can see it as a rule. Every sentence elements which you want to negate, there you can put the nicht right in front of it. Machen wir ein Beispiel. Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. Tomorrow, Lisa will bring the money to her father. And we have here Subjekt, das Subjekt. Wir haben das Verb. Position 3 ist hier das Adverb, Adverb. Dann haben wir ein Dativobjekt, Dative Object, und ein Akkusativobjekt. Also, wir haben 5 Satzglieder. We have 5 sentence elements. And because we have 5 sentence elements, this means we have also 5 options, 5 places where we can put the nicht. So, 5 Satzglieder, 5 sentence elements equals 5 options to put the nicht. What do I mean with that? Let's see how this looks. For example, like here. We have 5 sentences, almost the same sentence all the time, but you can see the nicht stands always on a different position. Now let's go deeper, let's go into detail. We start with the verb. Negation, Verneinung, Verb, negation of the verb. Same sentence, Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. Now we want to negate the whole sentence. It's not gonna happen. So, where we put the nicht is at the end. This is the exception of this rule. If you want to negate a whole sentence, then you just put the nicht always at the end of the sentence. So, it will be Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld nicht. She will not bring the money tomorrow. Nummer 2, Verneinung von einem Adverb. Adverb, negation of an adverb. Same sentence, Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. Now we have the adverb morgen. Morgen ist das Adverb. Now we want to negate it, so it becomes Lisa bringt nicht morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. And if you have watched my other videos about sentence structure in German, if not, I'm gonna link a card right here on top. There, I explained that the most important information, the most important element of the sentence information is always at the end of the sentence. And if you want to negate something, this means this information is the most important information. So this sentence right here is perfectly fine, but better would be if we change it to Lisa bringt ihrem Vater das Geld nicht morgen. So this morgen is actually the most important information. She is gonna bring the money. She is gonna bring it to her dad, but it's not gonna happen tomorrow. So this morgen is the information we wanna emphasize on. So we put it at the end of the sentence and therefore you have to put the nicht right in front of it. And if you wanna make it more clear, then you can add some information. For example, you can say, aber sie bringt es ihm übermorgen. But she will bring it to him the day after tomorrow. Nummer 3. Possessivartikel, die Verneinung von einem Possessivartikel. Negation of a possessive article. Same sentence, der gleiche Satz. Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. Now we have this ihrem Vater. Ihrem Vater is a possessivartikel. Ihrem. So if you want to negate this, you put this nicht right in front of it. So it becomes Lisa bringt morgen nicht ihrem Vater das Geld. She is gonna bring the money tomorrow, but she is not gonna give it to her dad. So again, here the information, the most important information is this ihrem Vater, this Dativobjekt mit einem Possessivartikel. So to make it better understandable, usually we would put this at the end of the sentence and then it would become Lisa bringt morgen das Geld nicht ihrem Vater. And if you have a possessive article and you use a negation on it, then usually we continue the sentence. You can continue, for example, like this, sondern ihre Mutter, but to her mom. So again, she will bring this money tomorrow, not to her father, but to her mother. Nicht kommt vor dem Possessivartikel. Nummer 4, bestimmter Artikel, definite article, same sentence, gleiche Beispiel. Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. Das Geld ist ein bestimmter Artikel. When you want to negate it, it becomes Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater nicht das Geld. And here you can see it's already on the last position. This is perfect. You don't have to change anything. So the meaning of the sentence, Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater nicht das Geld, would be she brings something to her dad tomorrow, but it's not the money. Because we negate the money. So we don't negate the whole thing or the verb. She is going to bring something, but it's not the money. And again, if you have a negation of a definite article, usually we add an information. For example, such as, aber sie bringt ihm ein Geschenk. But she will bring him a gift. So she's not going to bring the money, but she will bring him a gift. Das letzte ist Eigennamen. Eigennamen sind proper names. Gleiches Beispiel, Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. Lisa ist ein Eigennamen. If you want to negate it, it becomes nicht Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. So somebody is going to bring the money tomorrow to her dad, but it's not Lisa. So again, it makes more sense if you add an additional information to this sentence, such as, for example, aber Hans bringt es. Hans is going to bring it. So it's not Lisa, nicht Lisa, aber Hans. Bonus tip. Verb, das Verb. We just did this before, the same sentence. Negation of the verb. Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld. Lisa bringt, bringt ist das Verb, das Hauptverb an zweiter Position. That's the verb on the second position. If you want to negate it, it becomes Lisa bringt morgen ihrem Vater das Geld nicht. Nicht is always at the end. That's what we had so far. So the rule is Verb auf Position 2, if the verb is on position 2, you need to put the nicht at the end of the sentence. Now, we have situations where we have two verbs. For example, in perfect, in present perfect. So the sentence could be, Lisa hat gestern das Buch gelesen. Lisa hat gestern das Buch gelesen. Das ist perfect, that's present perfect. So we have here, haben, hat, ist das Hilfsverb, ist auxiliary verb, und gelesen, gelesen, das Partizip, von lesen, lesen ist das Hauptverb. If you want to negate this sentence, it would become, Lisa hat gestern das Buch nicht gelesen. Lisa hat gestern das Buch nicht gelesen. Also nicht kommt vor das Hauptverb. So the rule is, if you have two verbs, bei zwei Verben, ist die Regel, nicht kommt vor dem Hauptverb. Also if you have two verbs, nicht always comes right in front of the main verb. There is another situation, zum Beispiel Modalverben, modal verbs. There you usually also have to use a second verb. For example, Lisa muss heute arbeiten, she has to work today. Muss ist das Modalverb von müssen und arbeiten ist das Hauptverb. So if you want to negate this, again becomes Lisa muss heute nicht arbeiten. Also nicht kommt vor das Hauptverb. Same rule like before in perfect. If you have two verbs, then nicht stands always right in front of the main verb. Zusammenfassung. Let's do a quick summary. Nummer 1. Nicht steht vor dem Satzglied, das wir verneinen möchten. Nicht stands always in front of the sentence elements, which we want to negate. Nummer 2. Nicht steht am Satzende, wenn wir das Verb auf Position 2 verneinen. So if the main verb is on position 2, then you have to put nicht at the end of the sentence. Und Nummer 3, bei zwei Verben steht nicht vor dem Hauptverb. If you have two verbs, such as in present perfect or for example with modal verbs, then you have to put nicht right in front of the main verb, which is at the end of the sentence. Hausaufgaben, ihr habt Hausaufgaben. Und zwar, it's gonna be a little bit a tricky one, the sentence I don't like to sing. In English, I don't like to sing, which is not really true. I like to sing a little bit, but this sentence translated into German. Was ist richtig? Nummer 1. Ich singe nicht gern. Ich singe nicht gern. Oder Nummer 2. Ich singe gern nicht. Ich singe gern nicht. Both sentences are correct, but the meaning is a little bit different. And there's only one solution for this. So which one, number 1 or number 2, is the proper translation for I don't like to sing? Let me know down in the comments which answer is correct, 1 oder 2. If you want to know more about the positioning of nicht with more examples, there are actually 8 different situations, then just click this video right here. And if you want to know more about the difference between nicht oder kein, then you can watch this video right there.